how it works. But sometimes, because of the grace that is in your life, people will hate you. You will fall into some kind of trouble. Things will turn negatively against you. But at the end, that same grace will deliver you from those troubles. Are you there? Because of the grace of God, people will hate you. Joseph's brothers hated him because of the grace of God in his life. Someone will ask himself, why am I worshiping God and there's still suffering like this? Why do I say I'm following God and things are beginning to become more tighter than before? It is because of the grace. The grace that is in your life is so huge and the enemy cannot fight against it. So what we are seeing, it is just the surface, but in the inside, the grace is working miracles for you. The Bible says Joseph was inside the prison. Then one morning, two prisoners got up and they were sitting down. They were very, very sad. Are you there? He asked them, what was the problem? Because even in the prison, he was the prefect. So the prison warden did not care what Joseph was doing. And if they want to take record of anything in the prison, the warriors will come and ask Joseph. And whenever Joseph tells them, that is what they will do because of the grace of God. Are you there? When you are suffering, God is part of the suffering. That's why when you are rejoicing, let God be part of your rejoicing. Now, these two people who got up early morning, one was a baker of bread, and one was a wine supplier, or he gives wine to the king. The one who always gave wine to the king said, I dreamt, then I saw vine tree. It had three branches, and vine came from all of them and grew and became bright. I took the vine, squeezed into a cup. I gave it to the king, and the king was holding it, about to drink it. Then I woke up. Joseph said, that's a good dream. You were cast into the prison because you offended the king. The three branches stand for 3 days, and the vine and the cup you saw in a dream, it will happen after 3 days. The king will bring you out, then he will promote you to go back and do the same job you are doing, and you'll be giving wine to the king again. So it will happen in your life. That whatever has gone wrong in our life this week, the Lord will change it right now. Then again, the other man came to him. After he saw that a friend has had a good interpretation, he said, oh, me too, I dreamt. So what did you dream? He said, I was carrying three baskets on my head. Then inside the basket, there was Yogogolo, a Gembolo, Akosombogolo. Are you there? We those who are coming from Volta region, there is a bolo called Akosombogolo. Then we have Yevubolo. Are you there? You say all kinds of bread were in the basket. But as he was carrying the basket and he was walking to go and give it to the king, bears and all kinds of bears came and they started eating the bread. Joseph interpreted it for him. He said, the three baskets stands for 3 days, and the king will bring you out from prison. But he will take your head and give your body. to the banks of the earth. He started crying.
But
there was nothing he could do about it. Even in a prison, God was with Joseph. The same way as the year is rolling to the end, the same God who ushered into the year 21 and led you to this day will be with you to the end. Somebody receive. I don't know whether it's true or false. The Kiagbelega is the only one who can tell me. Are you there? Oh, amen.
Amen.
The Bible says that because of the grace that have located Joseph, one day God brought a dream into the king's bed. And the king was sleeping. Then he had two dreams. The first one was this. He had a dream that he was standing by a river now. How many of you know that the water lake we are drinking is a tribute of River Nile? The Nile is from Egypt, a very big river It's very big and sometimes ships fly on it. So it came through Niger. Part of it, Nigeria, Ivory Coast, then branched small into our Ghana. And after they dammed it, it spread and became a huge river. Are you there? This king dreamt he was standing by the river. Then he saw that big cats, very huge, were eating around the river. Then again he saw that some fiancas seem useless, ugly, seven of them came from the river. And when they saw those eating, they opened their mouth. They swallowed them. Then the king woke up. What kind of dream is this? Then he jumped again. He saw one corn, one stick of corn, but on it were seven stars. Seven. The corn, seven were on one star. Like this. Then the corn said, seven. Very fat, very strong, very thin, very nice, beautiful to eat. Then again, he saw that another one has also come up, but this one was sickly corn, but selling on it, and he started eating the fat corn. Then he woke up. He said, "Big dream, I don't understand." Now he gathered everyone in Egypt for interpretation. Nobody could interpret the dream. I am telling you something. God is about to do something. When the grace locates you, your family will get together for solution to a problem. They will never find a solution. I do the same for you. Receive. May the wisdom of God come to your life. That will separate you from everyone. That will make you a special person in your family. That before they take the decision, they have to call you. And whatever you say will be the final. Receive. The Bible says that. Now, when you are looking for solution, the camera now got to his senses. Because everybody in Egypt was worried. So he said, now I've reminded myself. I've seen against someone for 2 years. He said there was a guy in prison. Four of them drank. And the guy gave them decapitation. And he came to pass. He told the king. The king said, come on. Go for Joseph. Go and bring him back. Now that day, when they went to Joseph, he was dirty in the prison. He was wearing dirty clothes. He was wearing tattered clothes. Maybe his hair was grown too much. His hair has grown too much. But that day, when the grace came on him, they took him to a barber shop and they paid for it. Somebody is paying for a debt right now. Somebody is paying for a debt right now. God is paying for a debt right now. God is paying for a debt right now. Somebody receive. Hey, every me na mocha. That same God will do a bigger miracle this week. sick, expect some big miracles. Expect something great. Someone is looking for money. That money is coming to you this week. I'm telling you that someone is expecting a door to be open, an opportunity to come. I am prophesying to your life by the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. That thing they are expecting, the Lord our God of this house will suppress you. In the name of Jesus, he will suppress you. And you shall be filled with laughter. You shall be filled with dancing. And people will ask you, why are you dancing? Why are you laughing? And you think they cannot understand. And you will tell them that. Say, God is saying, Joseph did not eat any food. He was still in prison, and all hope was lost. And suddenly he had a knock at the door. He said, "Who is there?" He said, "I am the warden." The captain says, "We should bring you out." And when they brought him out, they took him to the bathhouse. And Joseph had to bath and had to shave his head. And they put the better clothes on him. Today, God is changing your situation. You're suffering to laughter. You're suffering to dancing. I never shut your life. According to the word of the Lord, so shall it be. As you think about Joseph, so will he do for you also. Receive it right now. As the year is rolling to the end, and you don't know what to do, and your mind is wanting, the Lord is going to suppress you. On Saturday, I had a phone call. Somebody told me that she was now snatching after she has given all she had to do something for God. She had nothing and she sat in the hall and was talking to God that, "God, I don't have anything. Then she had a call. Then the call said, "What is it?" It was her brother. The brother said, "I have received a direction that I should call you and give you money." He said, "Let the money come." Before she could check, 500 Ghana was on the phone. That same God of mercy, that same God of grace will do it for you also. Are you there? Joseph now went to the king. The king narrated his dream. He said, "Oh, this one is small. Because of the grace of God, I'll give you the interpretation. The interpretation is in the hands of God." He took the king, the seven cows, stand for 7 years. The seven corn, fat, stand for 7 years. 7 years. There'll be food. There'll be prosperity. The fiancer cow, seven. And the fiancer corn, seven. Which came to swallow the bigger one. Stands for adversity. Stands for hunger. 7 years food. There'll be 7 years no food on the land. The king said, "What shall we do?" Joseph told the king, "Let's build silos in every town, in every village. Let everybody farm and take 5% of your farm produce as taxes so that they'll keep it in the silos. So when hunger comes to the whole world, Egypt alone will have food to supply the whole world." I'm telling you that the grace of God has power to change evil situation to become good situation. Imagine that in that time, when hunger came, the whole world was hungry. There was no food anywhere. But Egypt alone had food for the whole world. When Jesus was born, the king at that time, Herodes wanted to kill him. God said, "Carry the small boy to Egypt. There are things that you must do. You must come to God. Then God can do it for you." Are you there? If Jesus was not carried to Egypt, Herodes would have stopped him. He would have killed him. So when you hear the sound, you hear the announcement that this one is going and you continue to speak away, then you are causing your own trouble.
Oh,
are you there? The same dream that Joseph had, which took him to prison, which made his relatives tell him, that same dream came to pass. After 13 years, the dream came to pass. 13 good years, the dream came to pass. That his father and all his brothers, they came and bowed down and they were worshiping Joseph. Are you there?
Yes.
Are you there?
Yes.
Are you there?
Yes.
I am telling you the power of grace of God.
Now, people are doing too many much.
Connect to the grace of God in his house. And this grace will lift you up. Connect to the grace of God. Because by 28 of this month, the angel of grace will go up again. Then another angel will descend to come and lead us to the new year. Put your hands together for Jesus Christ. Are you there? Are you there? In this house, we allow just 1 week for the angel to depart. It is left to you to connect to the grace of God. That all angel of God in charge of divine grace, locate me as you located Joseph. So shall he locate you too and give you everything you desire. May the Lord bless you. May the Lord increase you. That even when you are cast into prison, the grace will go and bring you out. When you are locked up in spiritual matters, the grace of God will deliver you. Anything that will be a barrier to you, the grace of God is ready to fight against that thing. Your life in Jesus' name. Amen. Shall we be on our feet?